It's no use, man. We can't find him.
No luck for me either. I didn't sense anything over there. The fog's so dense, it might be affecting my readings. I wish I could do better. I'm sorry.
Ted. Don't tell me he really went back to his world this time. We told him over and over that he could stay here. I guess that's all we can do right now. He plays dumb a lot, but he's attached to us deep down. He wouldn't disappear without saying anything, right?
I'm worried for Teddy myself, but let's trust in him and await his return. Right now, we must concentrate on the case. It won't be long before Namatame is transferred to another location. We must hurry, or we will miss our only chance to get his perspective on this.
You know, I've been thinking about the case since, but something just doesn't seem right.
Let's quickly review the facts. Of all the victims, only two were killed. Miss Yamano, the announcer, and Saki-san. From the documents we found in the car, we know Namatame had some sort of dealings with them. After that, there were multiple attempted murders in which we were targeted. It was only when he took Nanako-chan that we caught him in the act, identifying his modus operandi in the process.
When I hear you put it like that, sounds like the dude's guilty.
As a result of Namatame's arrest, the police admitted that Mitsuo Kubo was a mere copycat killer.
Back up to yesterday. Remember when you said Namatame didn't have a motive to kill the announcer? That's what's bothering me.
Right. Either he's completely nuts, or we're misunderstanding something.
You lost me.
She's trying to say that if Namatame is sane, then there may be facts in the case we don't know about yet.
Sane or insane? Sounds like a play I saw before.
When he talks about saving people, what does that actually mean? I don't think there's any doubt that it includes kidnapping people and throwing them into the TV.
Could he mean saving them through death? He did call himself a savior, and said that the other side is a wonderful world.
So they'll be saved if they die? What a bunch of crap! The bastard should have gone and saved himself! What do you think, Senpai? If you think about it normally, it's gotta be him. But there ain't nothing normal about that world anyways.
There's something I've been wondering about for a while. When we first encountered him, he said, "You're the ones I saved. Don't worry, I'll save this girl too." So, if he saves people by killing them, did he save us too? Wouldn't he actually have failed to save us?
You raise a good point. If he thinks that salvation comes only through death, his words to us make no sense. And another thing, the Namatame who appeared on the Midnight Channel said he failed to save Nanako-chan.
Well, maybe he really was trying to save the victims by putting them inside the TV. Come on, don't get all quiet like that. You guys know I just say the first dumb thing that pops into my head.
The possibility that he truly intended to save us.
But he's still the one who threw in Saki-senpai and that announcer, right? Sure, we haven't nailed down his motives, but that doesn't change the fact that he killed them. Or what? You think someone else was involved? What makes you think so? Warning letter? Oh yeah! Whatever happened to that thing?
If Namatame's the killer, he must have been the one who wrote it, right?
Let's review them. Yes, that's right.
Isn't that kinda odd? Would someone who thinks he's saving people by killing them write stuff like, "Don't rescue or kill"?
Yeah. And the "will be put in and killed" part doesn't make sense either. If the killer was writing it, Wouldn't it be more like, I'll put in and kill?
Hey, could this mean... Yeah, it's almost like someone else wrote this letter.
But only the killer would write such a letter and deliver it to Dojima-san's house, right? If someone else wrote it, that could only mean...
Dear God, since this is such an unusual case, I was absolutely convinced that other than the Kubo incident, there was one culprit.
So Namatame really was trying to save his victims?
Everything is exactly the opposite of what it first seemed. In Namatame's parlance, failing would have been the first two cases when the victims died. If he had used his method twice and failed both times, he would hardly have continued using the TV. And yet, he did. It all seems to suggest that someone else wrote this warning letter while observing the entire case.
Someone else? Then, it wasn't Namatame that killed Saki-senpai and the announcer?
We can't say for certain yet. We urgently need to speak with Namatame face to face.
How though? After what happened yesterday, they said they're gonna tighten security.
I have a plan. But there's no time to waste. Let's hurry to the hospital.